Good morning everyone and welcome to today's market commentary. So on early time frame in Nifty chart, we can clearly observe a double bottom chart pattern. So the neckline is around 11,280. So the reason that I have shifted market commentary earlier so that I can spot this double bottom chart pattern earlier and tell you all. So this double bottom chart pattern, and earlier also we had Nifty taking support at S1 of this week, and if we shift to the daily time frame, it also took support at S3 of this month. Along with that, as I told you, this 11,118 is going to be a strong support. So these three things combined together, Nifty is now bullish. So on breaking of this double bottom chart pattern, breaking in the sense it should close above this neckline very strongly and then it should go up. So our first target in this case, it can be 11,350, and the second target for day can be 11,400. So this is purely an intraday trade. So if the candle closes above this 11,348 to 11,394, if it goes even above this, then our third target for the day will be this gap. So 480 to 490, that is the third target for us in the day. So double bottom chart pattern, and there is a strong support that is taken earlier, weekly S1 and monthly S3, both were in conjunction. So if candle closes above this neckline, will be bullish. First target will be 11,348, second is 11,394, and the third target is 11,480 to 490. And the same in Bank Nifty. Even in Bank Nifty, you can see a double bottom chart pattern. Along with that, you have RSI bullish divergence as well in Bank Nifty. So price making lower low and RSI making higher low. So RSI bullish divergence, along with that you have double bottom chart pattern, and the immediate resistance can be 29,220. So if candle closes above this, our first target should be this one. And when we zoom out, next level of target for Bank Nifty, it should be 29,472. So 200 points on first hand and 200 points on the second hand. And finally, if it closes above 29,472 also, then R1 should be your third target. So this was Nifty and Bank Nifty. Then you have Piramal Enterprises on stocks. So Piramal Enterprises is actually sitting at a very strong support on daily time frame. So if this, so this price level is now going to be a very crucial zone for Piramal Enterprises. So this is the support zone for Piramal. Now the problem here is that RSI is already trading at 20. So this is a purely overbought zone. Now S2 of this month in conjunction with previous supports. So this should definitely act as a very strong support to Piramal Enterprises, and at any point we can expect a strong bounce from here. So even if it bounces back again, S1, which is 2200, very near to that 2178, that should be our quick target, because RSI is trading below 40. So even if it comes up, it might face a resistance near 40. So for us, the levels of RSI will always be 60 and 40, and it is trading way below 40. Current value is around 22. So even if RSI comes up and price goes up, RSI might face a resistance at 40. So even price will also face a resistance at 2178. Now if price settles below S2, clearly the prior bottom is our target, which is 1850. So below 2000, 1850 is our target. And if it bounces back from here, bounces back, very simple, it should make a bullish candlestick pattern here. When it makes a bullish candlestick pattern at this support, we can call it as a bounce back. So on closing basis of this green candle, you can start initiating your bullish positions, keeping 2000 as your stop loss and 2178 as your target. Whereas if it closes below this, it will be a short breakout, and you can short the futures or buy a put option in this and keeping 1850 as your target. The next stock is Mother Sun Sumi. Even this stock is also at a long-term trend line support. We need to wait and watch if that is being respected or not. So this is the long-term trend line support for Mother Sun Sumi. So even if it comes down at this point, it might face a bounce back. We can even apply this Fibonacci. So at 1.272, around that zone, we can expect a bounce back in Mother Sun Sumi. So this is actually a very strong support for the stock, a long-term trend line support. So if you join both these and extend towards the right, first time it took a support here, and now for the second time it is approaching the line. So we'll need to wait and watch if this support will be respected or not, but keep this stock in your bullish watch list. Then you have Muthoot Finance. So in Muthoot Finance, a clear trendline resistance is visible, and it is also trading below the central pivot point. RSI is also not so much satisfactory. Now, this can also be a falling channel. Not a perfect one though, but yes, if we be flexible on plotting these patterns, so this can be considered as a falling channel. Now what happens here is, since the value of RSI is not above 60, what can happen is the central pivot point of this month will act as a magnetic level, and it will pull the price towards itself. When it reaches to 600, and if it closes above that, we'll start initiating our bullish positions. So this trendline resistance is not the decision factor for us. The central pivot point is the decision factor. Along with that, RSI also should come above 60. Only then we'll be bullish in Muthoot Finance. And if that happens, we know what to do. R1 should be our target for the month. 30 rupees, which is going to be 5%. Now, if you want to make quick profits in this, if you want to take benefit of this magnetic level, you can keep this as your resistance level. And if price closes above this, you can immediately start initiating your bullish trades. So this is a common resistance point, 581. So if stock closes above this 581, even then also risk takers can enter this, and their final target should be 600. And you have Bajaj Auto. So in Bajaj Auto, first is there is a long-term trend line support here, and along with that you have 0.786 acting as a support. From there we could see a quick bounce back, and as retail traders, what we can do is we can draw a falling wedge here. So on break of this falling wedge and on break of the central pivot point, we can be bullish on Bajaj Auto. now. Clearly evident support is seen to us. So for us as retail traders, the important level is 29.75. Above that, we'll be bullish on this particular stock. So these are the stocks and indices for today. Thank you all for joining.